Caledonia Mining Corporation is a Toronto-listed and AIM-listed mining company, and it's just this minute announced a revised investment plan and production projections for its Blanket Mine in Zimbabwe. Well, we're joined now by Mark Learmonth, who is the Vice President of Investor Relations and Business Development at Caledonian. When people hear the words revised investment plan, we immediately think you're cutting back. Is that the case?
No, far from it. I mean, what's been happening at Blanket over the course of this year is that, you know, fundamentally it's a good little operation, a very low-cost producer. But as we've announced, we've made a couple of announcements in the course of the year, which to the effect that we're struggling to get the tonnages we wanted, we're struggling to get the grades we wanted, and so production has been a little bit lower than we'd expected. And that, on top of the lower gold price, has encouraged us to look at our long-term, medium-term investment plans at Blanket, and actually we've come to the conclusion that we need to spend more money, increase our investment, to increase our rate of expansion, so that we can access more resources, more deeper resources, and better resources more quickly. So the announcement we've put out just now is to increase our investment from about sort of $37 million up to $50 million over the next 3 years, and another 20 on top of that, with a view to doubling production from about 40,000 ounces to 80,000 ounces. And as we do that, as we increase production, Blanket's got a very high cost base, and we're very confident that as we increase production, we can get our costs down to a very low level. So no, it's not cutting back at all. It's actually the opposite.
What exactly are you going to be investing in? You're saying like getting to sort of deeper reserves and getting the cost base down. But I mean, how are you going to do that? What technology are you going to employ?
That's quite good. The first thing we're going to do is we've got to improve the underground logistics. I mean, our mine's not dissimilar really from sort of the Northern Line in London. It's full, you know, we can't transport any more stuff on the infrastructure that we've got. So the first thing we've got to do is we've got to build a new tramming loop, 750 meters below surface, which just gives us the capacity to move more material more quickly. And it's only when we've done that that then we can actually start to sink a new shaft. So doing that tramming loop, that won't cost very much. That only costs about $1 million. It'll take us about 9 months to do it. Once we've done that, then we can start the process of sinking a new shaft, which is going to go straight from surface all the way down to just below 1,000 meters below surface. And this is a very big shaft. It's going to be 6 meter diameter, and it will be the focal point of the mine going forwards. We can transport, you know, all of the stuff that goes down the mine, including men, all the stuff that comes up the mine, sort of the waste and the ore, will come up and down that new shaft. Increase our operating efficiency, but crucially, it let us get into the deeper level ore reserves much more quickly.
So how's that going to be financed?
All internally. Blanket's a very strong cash generator, even at the current gold price. It generates significant cash. And Caledonia also has quite significant cash on its balance sheet. So what we're expecting to do is that all of the investment will be funded by Blanket, the Zimbabwean subsidiary, using its internally generated cash flows. All that will mean is that we get dividend flows out of Blanket. All that will mean is that from now until probably the first quarter or perhaps the middle of 2016, those dividends from Blanket will be suspended whilst it uses all of its cash generation to reinvest in these projects. And then after that, it will then resume dividend payments at a higher level than we've been getting historically. So we absolutely don't see any need for Blanket to raise money. We certainly don't see any need for Caledonia to raise money. And to the extent that Blanket might need a little bit of additional funding, well, Caledonia, the parent company, has the cash resources to do that. But that's not something we actually envisage at this stage.
So your aim is to get the cost of production reduced as well. That makes sense, certainly when the price of gold is declining. You know, how much are you trying to reduce it by, and what's your outlook on the gold price?
Well, I think today's given a very fairly stark warning as to where the gold price can go. And that we're not in the business of the forecast of the gold price. We're just in the business of trying to run as efficient a gold operation as we can, because the best way to withstand a low gold price is to make sure that you're one of the most efficient producers. And we believe we are probably the lowest cost underground producer in Africa. So we can, even at our current range of production, we can see our cash costs in the high 500s, certainly below $600 an ounce. More than half of Blanket's costs are fixed. And so as we increase production, we're very confident that we can get that cost base down even further. How low it goes, there's all sorts of clever people, these analysts in London, who'll be able to work that out. But once you're in the 500s, pretty much you're a low-cost producer, and actually you're pretty well insulated from any untoward activity in the gold price.
All right. Mark Learmonth, thank you very much indeed for joining us there, the Vice President of Caledonia Mining Corporation.